Hey there kids, welcome. Week 6 of lockdown, Fullies Kids Online. It's so great to have you with me. I don't know where you are, maybe in your kitchen, living room, bedroom. The main thing is you are here and you are ready to learn something new about God today with all of us. It's going to be a nice one today. We have our normal Bible story. We have a visitor you'll meet. And then we also have a great song at the end for you guys to sing along. And the special thing about this song, it's made out of Lego. So maybe you can do something like that yourself. Now, today we want to talk about temptation. What in the world? That's a big word for some of you. Temptation. What does that mean? The easiest way to explain temptation is actually, I'm sure, something that you have heard in the last couple of weeks. How many of you had your moms or dad tell you not to touch your face? Even on the TV, the president said, don't touch your face. Now, that's something that's really easy. But I'm sure even now, when I'm telling you not to touch your face, some of you are thinking, oh, I just want to touch my face. Because I tell you, you're not allowed to do it, and it's not that big a deal for some of us. We think, oh, I can just touch. It's not going to make any difference. Isn't it always like that? Often, we get told not to do something, and that's exactly what we want to do then. That is what we call temptation. Temptation is when we are enticed to do something that we are not supposed to do. And today we are going to look at temptation. So I think the easiest way for me to make sure you understand what temptation is for me to introduce you to my friend. He is going to show you exactly what temptation is. Unfortunately, because he is actually going to get into quite a bit of trouble because he could not resist temptation. So, let's meet our friend for today. Mom! Mom!
Yes, dear?
Can I have some of the muffins?
No, it's for Grandma.
Just one, please.
Maybe later.
They look so good. Okay, Mom said I can't have it, so I can't have it. No, no muffin. Maybe if I just look at the muffins. Oh, they look so pretty. Oh, look at that. Oh. No. Mom said no muffins. Maybe I can just sniff the muffin. Oh. No muffins. Mom said no muffins. She said I can't eat it. Maybe I can just hold it in my hand. Ooh, look at this. Oh, it's so good. Oh, beautiful muffin. Oh, no. Mom said no muffins. Wait, she said I can't eat it. Maybe I can just put my tongue and just taste it. Just. Oh, it's so good. She's not gonna miss one. Okay, no. Mom said no muffins. I can't have the muffins. Smells so good and it tastes so good. I'm sure she won't. It's just this three, four. So if I eat just the one. Oh. Oh no. What have I done? What have I done? Oh no. That is exactly what temptation is. His mom told him that he's not allowed to have the muffins, but instead of walking away and doing something else, he kept on looking at it, sniffing it, tasting it with his tongue. Never do that. And then he ended up eating the muffin and feeling very, very bad about it. That is exactly what temptation does. We know we're not supposed to do something, but the more we think about it, the more we stay around that thing we're not allowed to do, we sometimes end up doing exactly what we are not allowed to do. So how do we solve this? The best way is to have a look at what Jesus did. Did you know that Jesus was also tempted? Yes, there's a wonderful account in the Bible of Jesus going into the desert and Satan himself coming to tempt Jesus in the desert. So let's see what Jesus did when he was tempted.
Come and see the temptation of Jesus. This is Jesus.
Hey-o!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. Jesus was born in Bethlehem and grew up in Nazareth, where he grew in wisdom and favor with God and man.
Oh, I see.
Jesus was baptized by John, and God showed John that Jesus was his chosen one. Then Jesus was led by the Spirit into the wilderness among the wild animals.
Oh, hey there, friend.
For 40 days and 40 nights, Jesus didn't eat anything. So he was hungry. Satan came to him and said,
"Hey,
if you are the Son of God, tell these stones to become bread." Jesus knew God's word, and so he answered, "No. The word of God says people don't live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God." And so Jesus passed the first test. Then Satan took him to Jerusalem and said, "If you are the Son of God, jump off.
Aww.
For the word of God says he will order his angels to protect you, and they will hold you up with their hands so you won't even hurt your foot on a stone."
Wait.
But Jesus said, "The word of God also says, you must not test the Lord your God."
Now.
And so Jesus passed the second test. So Satan took him to the peak of a high mountain and showed him all the kingdoms of the world and all their glory. Satan said, "I will give it all to you if you kneel down and worship me." But Jesus said, "Get out of here, Satan, for the word of God says you must worship the Lord your God and serve only him." Then Satan went away and angels came and took care of Jesus. And so Jesus passed the third and last test.
And that is exactly how we can walk away from temptation. Jesus in the desert for all those days, no food, and Satan comes and tempts him, and all Jesus had to do was to do what the devil wanted him to do. But of course that's wrong. Jesus can't obey the devil, and he knew that. And even though he was so hungry, and the devil tempted him with ruling the world and all those things, Jesus knew that it was more important to obey God. And in fact, he didn't just know it. Every time he was tempted, he would actually speak the word of God back at Satan. And eventually, the devil had to leave, and then the angels came and they helped Jesus. That is such a good example for us. Number one, it's great because it shows us that Jesus was also tempted. So when we are tempted, we can ask him to help us because he knows what it feels like to be tempted. And number two, it shows us how to stand up and actually get through when we are tempted. So, our friend with the muffins, he didn't do a very good job. Instead of walking away when his mom said, "Don't eat the muffins," he kept on sniffing it, tasting it, and getting closer to it. And that is the worst thing that you could do. And another thing that's very important is actually when Jesus taught us how to pray, he included in there that we should ask God to not let us get caught up with temptation. Now you are going to get tempted every day, probably of your life. So let's think of some examples. You are playing and your brother or sister or cousin or someone else is playing with a toy and then you want to play with that toy, but it's their turn. Now you might be tempted to just grab that toy from them and play with it, because maybe you are older, or maybe you're just stronger, or maybe you're just going to grab it and run away. Is that the right thing to do? No, you have the choice to actually ask God, God, please help me not to want to play with that toy now, and then to play with something else. Or maybe, like our friend with the muffins, mom says, don't eat it, and then you want to eat it, and instead of staying around it and looking at it and thinking how nice it would be, you can ask God to help you not to take that now and then just to walk away. And you know what? God is always going to help you to do that. So I hope this week, every time you are tempted to do something that's not the right thing to do, I want you, first of all, to ask God to help you, and then second of all, turn your back and walk away. It's as simple as that. But it's also very difficult if we try and do it by ourselves. I'm going to end today's session with a nice song. And this song is about how life would be without Jesus. We just saw that Jesus can help us when we are tempted. Imagine if there wasn't a Jesus. Imagine if God would not be able to help you and you would have to help yourself when you are tempted. It would be very difficult and almost impossible. So this song is all about what we would be like if we are without Jesus, and then obviously how great it would be if we are with Jesus. Now, this song is actually done, the video is done with Lego pieces. And we've done a couple of these at Fullies Kids. So remember, we have the song about the big, big house. But this one is a song by Toby Mac, Me Without You. So maybe after listening to it, if you have Legos, maybe you can do something similar like this and do a picture or make something that shows how we should resist temptation. Maybe you can do the story of Jesus in the desert. So let's go into this week. Let's remember that God is on our side and He will help us with anything that we need help with. And let's not fall for temptation. See you next time.
Raindrops rolling off my brim. Street lights got the pavement glistening. Touchdown, I fall into your arms, right where I belong, your everlasting arms. And where would I be without you? I'd be packing my bag when I need to stay. I'd be chasing every breeze that blows my way. I'd be building my kingdom just to watch it fade.